What is up, guys? Max here, and welcome back to another tutorial. So, today I'm going to do something a little different. It'll probably take a lot longer than usual, but I want to start a new series where we kind of cover, you know, movie sequences, title sequences, anything that's cool, and what we see right now that I think is awesome. So, in doing so, I want to cover how to make the Stranger Things opening title sequence. Really, really cool. Let's give it a watch and talk about it. So, let's turn the sound off for copyright reasons. Really, really cool. Really retro red titles coming in. I don't know what that is. That's an N, I'm pretty sure. That's kind of glowy. There's like a texture to it almost. Something really, really awesome. You can see all these edges that are moving and glowing. The glow's like moving. Quick fade. All these cool retro titles. And to the final reveal, to the, I guess you'd call it the logo. But if you hadn't seen the show, it's really awesome. It's on Netflix. It's an amazing show. It is great. You know, I'm not a big TV show guy or a show guy in general. I really like movies. And when I saw the trailer to this, I thought it was a movie. And we watched the first episode, and I was like, what? There's more? Like, yeah, it's a show! I was like, I was completely blown away. So I like shows that look like movies, basically. But this is how I would make this. It's not going to be exact. It'll be a nice, cool version of this. Because I'm not exactly sure how they made this originally. It could be all made in After Effects, or it could be all made with practical effects. Who knows? But we're going to go for it, and follow the correct structure of making something like this. So, and right before we get started, I wanted to mention one thing. I have rebuilt my website into something cool and interactive. So, we now have a blog. So you can go on here, check out my blog. I have all my updates, my giveaways, my videos. It's a really cool, easy way to interact, leave a comment. I'm even writing a blog about the making the Stranger Things animation. So that could be really cool. Brand new. It's still under some work, but we're getting it going. Also, we have a store. So, go into the store, and people always ask for my project files. Now, I decided to kind of start selling these files for really cheap, less than the price of a cup of coffee, because it is a really cool and easy way for me to support this channel and make more things like this. So, I'm going to give this a go, see how this works. But also, I have freebies. So, there's a lot of files that I'll give away for free. For instance, the Olympic Torch file and this Stranger Things file. So, this entire project file you can download right now for free. And also, 40% off any order over $10. Enter the promo code PUGSFORLIFE at checkout. And finally, on the homepage, I always have some kind of featured product and also the giveaway. So enter to win will always be there. Check back for more stuff. And feel free to subscribe to the newsletter where you get all my blog updates, crazy awesome stuff. You'll get all the giveaway updates, all my announcements, videos, etc. They will be there. So go check out my new website. I hope you enjoy it. It was a lot of fun being built. Other than that, let's get this thing done. First off, we're gonna make a really organized project. So, we're gonna do a folder. Call it number1_main comp. Really sweet, right? So right click, new composition, main comp. 1920 by 1080, 23.976 frames per second, and 51 seconds long. Because this title sequence is 51 seconds long. Click OK. And then what we're going to do, I'm going to cheat a little bit. And you know, maybe we'll switch this up into like a two-part series tutorial, because this is going to take a while. But we're going to go through this whole thing. And then I'll make a video about the high level, how to make it, where it's like a two-minute video on how to make it. Like Film Riot does. I think it's really awesome. I really like their channel. But drag this into here, and this is like my cheap version of making it. Let's scale this up to about right here. It's got, yeah, 150% to make it exact. But we're going to go through and just make the bones. And to note one more time, I will be using some paid plugins for this tutorial, because this is a more advanced tutorial with some really cool stuff. So, paid plugins. So, I'm sorry, I try to avoid paid plugins in all of my tutorials, because I know people don't want to buy stuff but sometimes you just got to because they're great. They're really helpful. Not endorsed by anybody. I'm just saying there's some things that I have that I just kind of need. Hey, there's Cinema 4D. Look at there. So let's go to a frame where we like it, the ending frame. And let's lock this layer, zoom out, and make some shapes. Grab your pen tool and boom, 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 boom. Shape number one. Shape number two. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, it's almost exact. And it's not going to be perfect by any means. Let's actually give these shapes a fill. Let's make them white for now so we can actually see the difference. Oop, oop. Click on the other shape. Get rid of the stroke. Don't need that. Click on this shape. Hey, they're both. Got a good fill. Okay. We got two shapes. Now, we need to cut these shapes. So, frames ends right here. So, option bracket. Go back in time. And about right here they start. So, right here. Option. Oop, oop. Wrong one. Command Z. Option bracket. This side. Cool. And now what we're going to do is actually right-click, new, camera. Make a camera into our scene. Click OK. Turn these two layers on like they're 3D layers. Right-click, new, null object, creating an object to control our camera. I like putting the anchor point in the center because I'm like that. Then turning this into a 3D layer and then parenting it, or a camera, excuse me, depends on this. Cool. So, right here is when they go away, this frame. And then back here. Okay, so right here. P for position. Keyframe it. I'm pretty sure that's the Z. Yes, the Z. You go back in time, and we're going to zoom. Not the Z. We're going to zoom these babies out. Keep going. Two right there. So when it plays, it should follow these things exactly. It's not perfect, but it's pretty darn close. Maybe we'll move them forward a little bit. Back into our Z. So doom 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 doom. I like it. Cool. That part's done. Now what we're gonna do pre-compose this layer, or all these layers we just created, and call it clip one. New folder, call it 2_clips. Now I'm doing that because, oh, main comp right here. And we can get rid of this, don't need it. Delete. New folder, 3_footage. Keeping everything organized, really helpful. So the clips will be each little sequence we make, and the main comp is the top comp we make. Cool. And what I like to do too is actually go into here and actually go in and trim these down. Composition, trim comp to work area. Jump back out to main comp, and now it's right here. And yes, I know, I gotta move it over to right there. But it works, you know, just like that. Now it's this side. And we will do it again. So now it's an N. I'm pretty sure this is an N. And this is where we get to find out what font we're using. So grab your text tool, click right here, and type an N. And we're using this font called Benguet Bold. Found it online. I actually Googled what font does Stranger Things use in their title sequence, and I found it. So find it online, or maybe I'll leave a link in the description. So bump up this font. So click it. Scale it up a whole bunch. I mean, we gotta get this thing really up there. Almost there. And I don't think this is exact. I mean, I'm not gonna spend too much time on the exactness of the shape to be just like it. We just want the look and the movements. All right, so once we got that font, we're gonna right click and create shape from text. Sweet. Now what we'll do is take this fill, turn it off, and turn our stroke on. Bump up the stroke a little bit, bump up the volume. And that's about right. Ooh. I mean, see, it's a little squished, I think. Maybe if we move it in, hit S on our keyboard, do that. Bring it back a little bit. Bring it up some. Then bring this back down. I will never get it right. This looks fine. And it seems to be moving down that way. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward. So let's move it right here. This arrow looks pretty good. Click S, keyframe it, hit P, keyframe it, go back in time to right here. Move it up on our thing. And it should just follow it. Perfect. And like before, do that. Do that. Right click, pre-compose, clip 2. End it. I don't know why I'm doing this. Jumping in. And there's got to be a shortcut. I know somebody in the comments is going to leave a shortcut that says you can just click this button to make your area comp automatically trim. But you know, whatever. Whatever, man. Jump back to main comp. See, it moved and it's all trimmed now. We're back in action. Actually, zoom in really close. Right there. It's like a layer. That needs to be right there. This needs to be right here. And this needs to appear right here. Click U on your keyboard to show the keyframes. Start right here. End right here. Then this follows this. For the most part, I mean, it's not perfect. It's gonna change right here. Down to the frame. Move this right here. Now this one was a little tricky. I did do a little research before I made this stuff. Yeah, I gotta have some understanding. I'm kind of winging it a good bit, I'll be honest. But we're going for it. Normally I prepare my tutorials a lot. I like to really know what I'm doing. I don't want to be fumbling as I'm making something. Because believe me, I'm not perfect. I mean, I do a lot of research. Ooh, that is not the size. S. Turn off the little thingy. Don't hit shift. You know, I like to really do my research and come in and look like I'm this amazing animator that knows exactly what he's doing. But a lot of it's, you know, just figuring stuff out and being willing to experiment. And then maybe an eye. Right there. That looks good. All right, so highlight both of these, right click, create, one at a time, I'm sorry. Create shape. We don't need these anymore. Go into here, stroke, fill off, stroke, fill off. Stroke needs to be a lot bigger, or a lot thicker. This whole letter needs to move over a little bit. I want to get at least one edge correct. Nah, that's good. That is 8. This means this will be 8. It's a lot thinner than that, actually. And this one, a lot thinner as well. 5? Does that make you better? Yeah, that's about right. Alright, And then we'll clip these off. And click P on our keyboard to keyframe both their positions. Move them over to where they need to be. This one's pretty long. All right, this, oop, not that one. Just the R. Yeah, but what I'll say, I try to do a lot of research. Really know my stuff before I, you know, do it. Ooh. That one needs to be right off screen, right about here. Get rid of this keyframe. And it changes, boom, 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 right there. Highlight both of these. Pre-compose, clip three. Where'd it go? Is it in main comp? It is. Put these in clips. Clip three. Yep. And then we're gonna go here and. At this point in our tutorial, we're just kind of making the skeleton. We're really just doing what needs to be done. And we move this back down the road. And line this up right there. Ooh, email. Work emails. I do have a full-time job. I work full-time in New York City as a video producer. So, gotta pay them bills. Student loans don't pay themselves. Am I right or am I right? Okay, so I don't know what shape this is. This one's totally new to me. I haven't actually done this one yet. So, this is an S. That looks like an S. This is the bottom of something. What is that? What has a bottom? No. It could just be the bottom of an S. And how is it moving? See, this is where I edit the tutorial, where it looks like I'm going really fast, but I'm really not. It's just going to be a shape. It's always a good one that I can just manipulate later. Stroke it up. Take this, right click, create shape from text. Turn the fill off. Turn the stroke on. What is this stroke? 70. Definitely not 70. Whatever. So right here starts. Take both of these. Turn it down like that. Go to the end. Scaling down. And. Oh! Back up. Remember, kids, to hit position on your keyboard. And click scale. To about right there. We move this over. Not that one. Move the bottom one over and scale it down until it fits. Just like that. Take this one, move it over, and also scale it down like that. And this edge of this S is completely different. And it's probably something they did with customizing the font. I'm not interested in figuring that out. But by all means, somebody else can do it. Precompose. Clip. Four. And before, just like we did. Go in here. It's going to be annoying because I just... ended the thing. Composition. Trim area to work comp. And almost perfect. this back down. Find the exact frame it changes. Go back out. Move. And boom. We got another S. All kinds of S's. I keep remaking it too. Should just keep it. This one looks pretty simple. Turn this one off. Command D, move it over. If I do that, give us the other side. And hit P, or take our fills. Oh, create shape from text. Create shape from text. Turn the fill off. Turn the stroke on. Turn the stroke on. Turn the fill off. Turn the stroke on. What stroke are we using? That one's more zoomed in. I guess it's more custom for each one because each one has a little more depth. It's a little larger. Move it down. Now a little larger. And believe me, this is like the bulk of the work, to be honest. Because once you get the motions down, you just stylize it. Which stylizing it is once you do one, you can literally copy and paste the rest. And you're good to go. Move it over. Right there. P in the keyboard. Keyframe it. S. Keyframe it. Move this thing up. Scale it down a little bit. Right there. Move this thing. That's an R. This is an R. Oh my gosh. Let me get rid of that. Sorry, guys. Fooled me right there. See? You know, I'm not perfect. By any means. Look at that, that is totally an R. Stretch it up right there. Create shape. Keyframe it. Position. Keyframe it. Turn the fill off. Turn the stroke on. This one has a stroke of 6, which is 6. And then right here. It was right here. The scale can be a little larger. Is it 1300? 1327? Just so it matches. Just like before, delete these. We don't need them anymore. Precompose clip 5. Pretty sure. Trim area to work comp. I think we're only like 20 minutes in right now, so not a bad time. And we're almost towards the end, which is like the fun part for everybody, where you actually make the letters. And move this over. Right. Maybe I'll speed this part up, you know, so you can kind of like, just you get what I'm doing. Just copying motions. Thank you. Clip 6. Trim area to work comp. A little bit further. Move it down a timeline. Let's turn this off for now because we're making a whole new thing that's kind of confusing. Oh, it's the last part right there. Sweet! N and a G. It's pretty obvious what those letters are. And this is, you know, a full-length tutorial. I mean, like, no skipsies. You know what I'm saying, man? We're gonna go all the way. Come on. Oh, I don't know the shortcut. Somebody's gonna comment the shortcut. I know it. I know it. I like you guys. I'm just kidding. You know what I'm doing? And I do my normal tutorials. I'm very structured. I'm all about it. But, you know, some of you guys are some passionate followers, and I enjoy that. I appreciate that. And maybe I'm annoying as hell. Who knows? Just like that. Main comp. That's at the beginning now. Always does that. Gotta get back where we were. I figured out a solution to never have to think about where it starts to come in anymore. Alright, so you got that. So these things start fading here. So T on your keyboard, click opacity. And right about there, it's completely faded out. Okay, it's gonna be right there. Turn this one back on. Hey, they're thicker than they used to be. This one. The stroke, my goodness, is 8. Let's make it 6. On all of these. Stroke down to 6, guys. Come on. Jump back in. You, sir, need to be in all kinds of different places. About right here. Close enough. And this is fully formed right about there. Fades in from 0 right about here. So is it fully formed? Fully formed. Ooh, right about there. And right click, ease out, ease in, ease out, ease in. Oop, it needs to be. A little bit longer. So jump into here. Composition settings. It's only 4.0. Let's do 5.0. Make this last a little. Oop, nope, nope. A little longer. Hit P. Use down the timeline. Page down, right there. And boom, we shall take a small break. All right, guys, that's it for this part. I hope you've enjoyed it so far. But as always, I'm Max. Please like and subscribe, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.